Joe, you're on the Run of Fez show.
I want to ask Fez if it's okay for a man to get another man a Valentine's gift if he's just a friend.
Oh, I think that should be reserved for lovers or potential lovers. I think, I don't think it should be a friendship thing. Although, I mean, little kids are the exception where you get little kids stuff for Valentine's Day.
Oh, my God! That's disgusting!
What are you saying?
I mean, like, parents get their kids something.
Pedophile!
Pederast.
What?
Pederast. That's disgusting, Fez. And that also gives you a bad reputation. That, and, of course, you always run people over with cars.
Not
when you're driving around. Thanks, Bruce.
Apparently, there was a Prius involved. A Prius.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm. Somebody's taking care of the environment one person at a time.
I think he stole a Prius. He carjacked a Prius and then got into that accident. That's what I heard.
Well, you know, what are you going to do? You know what I mean? You try to get along with everybody. At least I do.
So you can't give friends Valentine's?
I think you can give anybody anything. If Fez is dating children, then
I'm not.
That's what you just said.
It's okay if you're with a child.
The only platonic or non-sexual relationship it's okay to give Valentine's for is for kids.
What about your super in your building? Give him like a little Valentine's Day card. Like put on, I choose you. It'd be like a train there, like in The Simpsons.
Choose you to fix my sink. Thanks, dude.
I think it's nice.
That'd be a nice little thing.
Well, why would somebody give something to a child, like trying to date that child?
No, just as since it's a holiday and you would give a kid some candy or something like that.
Oh, my. Let me tell you, my children are 3 and 5, and I'll grab a gun and shoot somebody who tries to give them something.
Good.
Do you have a white van, Fez?
No.
Good.
White covered in cum, probably.
Crust.
Gay cum.
Just crusted. Crusted over.
How do you get in the van?
Oh, God.
Over the corpses of children.
And through the cum windows. Fez, you went too far today, buddy. I know that you were trying to T-bomb it, but you ended up teabagging it, didn't you?
Party at the Moontower.
Sounds just like the grandmother of the guy in the movie.
Party at the Moontower.
Party at the Moontower. Officer, I believe there's been a
party at the Moon Tower.
Try to send your cars and arrest everybody at the
party at the Moon Tower.
You sound so Floridian.
You do.
That's not good because it was supposed to be Texan.
Oh. Well, I don't know my southern states' accents.
She means Floridian, like retired. Grandma, what is everybody doing down there in St. Pete?
Party at the Moon Tower.
Moon Tower is her name for heaven.
Because there's a beer bus to heaven, too.
You're not on our on our emails anymore, huh?
No.
There's 6 people in these emails, and you're not one of them. It's from Gil. I'm just going to write back. Why isn't Michelle on this?
Oh, boom.
Did Gil hate you?
No, we love each other.
Oh, good. Not in a way that's breaking up your marriage.
No,
though, right?
No, that's what my husband's doing.
He's having a menage right now. You should be happy for him.
Because he's having a
party at the Moon Tower.
Let's see how many times we can play it before we stop liking it.
Never.
I bet the sun will go out first. I bet the sun will burn itself out before we stop enjoying
party at the Moon Tower.
I'm going to make that my ringtone.
They still do that? People still have ringtones?
I'd like to believe they do.
Yeah. Let's see.
Oh, you have your phone.
Yeah, I decided to bring it with me today. That way I can hear shit. But, because I always need to know, you know, when I want to
party at the Moon Tower.
That's good, because someone could call you and let you know about.
Steve and Philly.
Hey, since you're playing Soundbite Fez, do you have Fuck You, Ron Bennington?
No, my team isn't going to be on that. My team doesn't like to do that kind of shit.
I should have reminded Shelby to pull it.
Why? He was getting old news stories. He's still turning news stories that were 3 days old. They'd be 4 days by the time we got on the air.
This dude, it's V-Day. Did you guys hear about this?
Tell Ron that there seems to be the spirit of St. Louis has landed safely.
The stock market's crashed, have you guys realized?
Lindbergh's baby has just disappeared. You know, Lindbergh's baby would have been dead by old age now, so who cares what happened to it?
I care.
Really?
No.
They dropped that baby, taking him out of the house when they were kidnapping him. Dropped him. Fucking stupid-ass kidnappers. That's the reason we have an FBI to this day, because of that case.
Doesn't seem like kidnappers are usually the smartest of villains.
There's no such thing as a smart criminal. They're all fucking idiots. The only smart criminals are in movies. In real life, the big plot is always to take a fucking crowbar and smash open the window. They never come up with anything interesting.
I bet CSI, like, they're never really needed that often, since it's so easy to catch these
because
guys.
Because the fucking crook is normally sitting around with his dick in his hand. In my neighborhood, there used to be this this place where you could... It was a pharmacy, but it also had, it was like burgers and shit like that, right? So these dudes... I'll just say I knew them. That's all. I leave it at that. They fucking break in to start and steal Tylenols and Quaaludes. They get in through the window. They get fucking vials of it. They decide, let's start eating up here.
Oh, no.
Then one of them was hungry, put on the fucking grill, and starts cooking a burger. The ludes fucking kick in. They pass out with the burger fucking smoking up, setting off the alarm. Everybody in the town hears it but them, and the cops and fire department show up at the same time. That's how good a criminal is.
Every time you pause in any way, I think it's gonna you're gonna hit that button, and I get really happy.
Sure, go ahead, enjoy it.
Party at the Moon Tower.
But now you got him upset.
Oh no, I'm sorry.
Why is that upset, Fez?
Well, I mean, I think we got the point.
Party
Michelle.
At the Moon Tower.
I sound stupid when I say party
no,
at the Moon
it's
Tower.
Just a it's not.
Thank you,
party
Michelle.
At the Moon Tower.
You don't think that it's, sounds good, Fez?
It's no. So funny. The cadence is so funny. It's just a funny sounding thing.
It's like if they did Dazed and Confused, but at like a retirement home, it would sound like this. Where's everybody going tonight?
Party at the Moon Tower.
Then I'll meet you there at the Moon Tower. Right? Tuesday's gone with the wind.
Party at the Moon Tower.
You already told me.
It does kind of sound like, what's his face? What is his face?
Party at the Moon Tower.
The Kodiak, the Cadillac commercials.
No, the Kodiak.
The Kodiak Cadillac commercials.
It's the Kodiak
chew.
Bear.
For the chew. Kodiak chew.
That's what I like about corpses. They stay the same age.
Party at the Moon Tower.
All right, Michelle. He gets it.
You're mean, Michelle.
Yes.
We're all mean. I will also tell you this about that Keanu Reeves.
Yes.
Didn't miss a beat.
Hit it.
Went to the plate like a fucking champ.
Nice.
And that's, you know, that's fucking Flats from, you know, West End. True to West End always. He's not going to fuck around. He's Highland Gardens through and through. Hey, Jay, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hey, Ronnie.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, after those guys augured in from Skynyrd, Neil Young actually played Sweet Home Alabama the show afterwards.
How nice of him. Fucking plane crashed.
Yeah, and your phone answer thought it. No, I was talking about.
Rossington College used to play it, but nobody would be singing, and there would just be a spotlight on the empty thing, and then the audience would sing it. People would be crying and shit, and they were like, "We will never." First, they said, "We'll never play Freebird again," right? Then they played Freebird with just the light on it, and finally they're like, "Oh, go get his brother. Let his brother sing." You know, what the fuck? You know what I mean?
It's okay. At this point, it's okay.
I'm like, oh, so this is how we deal with death a little bit at a time, you know? But actually, we just started playing this for one reason.
Party at the Moontower.
This was the song. As it all started to come apart. Did you used to have keg parties in your neighborhood, like in the woods?
Yes, in Montana.
We did too.
Yeah.
Loved it. Chris, you have no idea what we're talking about,
no,
right?
No, keg parties in the woods sounds crazy.
Oh my God, it was so fun.
Yeah.
It'd be a
the funnest thing you could do.
Oh, so good.
Yeah.
We had a place called Paradise Dam, and we would do it by there.
Sounds fantastic.
It was great. It was so cold, too, because it's Montana, so you just get shit-faced. And then hope that you don't die from, you know, because you pass out and freeze to death.
Did we ever give out the Ed Byrne winners today?
No, we didn't.
We've been too busy with...
Party at the Moontower.
Why don't you grab them, put them together, and read them out? Oh, you haven't done it at all?
I don't have a computer here anymore.
But you didn't even do it over the weekend? We don't have it on a sheet?
No.
So we want to do it tomorrow?
Yeah.
Okay.
I can still get that Saving Private Ryan signed DVD, right?
Sure. A lot of the women found him to be a handsome man.
He's a very handsome man. He's no Chris Stanley. Oh. With his swarthy good looks.
I thought swarthy meant like greasy and weird.
Okay.
No, it does. Now I just feel embarrassed.
Tuesday's gone. Let's go over here to Bob in Illinois. You're on the Ron Fez show.
Jamont's party at the Moontower.
You're never going to be able to say it this good.
Party at the Moontower. Party at the Moontower.
And you don't want BL there, right?
Fuck you, Fez Wally!
I love it. Oh, by the way, Flats got fucking knocked out by Danny Archdeacon for trying to steal his tap. He said it was his tap, but no.
Yeah, whoever had the tap.
Flats never wants to hear that fucking story, but I heard it from enough people. Fucking Danny Archdeacon laid him out.
There's always one dude trying to steal a tap at a party.
I've been fucking places where people fucking tap was off there quick. Everybody went chasing after him. The guy fucking hit me with a car. That was in fucking Chester, too. Those animals.
Bad things go down in Pennsylvania.
Well, you know, and some good things. You know what I mean?
I mean, you were the miracle baby.
And birth of a fucking nation, you know. Thank you, Philadelphia. Bobby in Vegas got a question for you, Fezzy.
Hey, Fezzy, how do you feel about Sam Smith not thanking Tom Petty, your favorite singer, for his 4 awards?
I didn't see it.
Yeah, but you said you liked the pageantry and all the keeping up with the times with the... awards, that's why you somewhat keep up with it, right?
He probably should have thanked him then.
Well, he did, 12%.
He's trying to get you an anti-gay thing because Smith is gay. He's very gay. And he said this last night, I want to thank the man who broke my heart. Because now I could write songs like this. Well, that is with Tom Petty's help.
12%
of it.
Alanis Morissette, same thing.
For what?
Broke, got her heart broken. And then made that huge hit. And
I want you to know you fucked with the wrong chick, I'm gonna cut your nuts and make you eat them too.
And she also gave 12% to Tom Petty, so.
Yeah. Wow. We should all give 12% to Tom Petty.
He's basically the IRS.
You only give the IRS 12%?
Don't do
no
it.
No wonder you're always in a fucking run.
You really need to reevaluate your
Mark
financial.
In Virginia.
Ronnie B., I think there's a little paging Mr. Herman in Party at the Moontower.
Paging Mr. Herman.
Party at the Moontower.
Paging Mr. Herman.
Party at the Moontower.
Now it just caught me for the second. Why can't you enjoy this, Fez?
It sounds stupid.
It doesn't. It just sounds
fucking
funny.
How fucking stupid have I sounded all day?
It's awesome. That is an awesome drop.
I've been yelling. I yelled out Spouty for a fucking hour and 20.
That was funny.
Why didn't you jump in then?
I couldn't think of any Spouty-isms.
For Spouty.
How about Spout 20?
Smoke Spouty every day.
How about party at the Spout Tower? I wish I could, when you do it.
Party at the Moon Tower.
Right in the middle there, there's a metallic sound that's fucking amazing.
Party at the Moon Tower.
It's almost like you've taken a piece of steel and put it in your mouth.
Party at the Moon Tower.
It's amazing. That metallic is my favorite.
Maybe it's a crown. Some dental work.
You don't have to be so on the nose, big cat. You can go crazy with it. Let's go nuts with it. Let's get you in the full fucking V. You know what I mean? Let's cut that V down to your belly.
I'll look for a very deep V.
He's back to just being literal instead of
well, with the
crazy.
V-neck, you can show off your chest. With
I think put it on backwards. Make it look like a backless gown.
Don't wear your bra that day. That's they're ridiculous. These people are
Come on,
ridiculous.
They're gay.
Stop it, Michelle.
They're gay.
I don't care.
You know what?
That's okay. From
can I tell you something?
What?
They got called weirdos in their own shitty towns in Iowa where people used to throw rocks at them. So they come here to the West Village to be weird, you know?
And party at the Moon Tower.
And when you call them ridiculous and sick and effeminate.
Wait, sick?
Abominations, I heard her say, too.
Yeah. Where? What?
Against gold. You think Jesus wants to say something like that?
Well, no, that looks nice. I like that one.
Let me tell you something about my God. He doesn't have any gates. He doesn't make any mistakes. I wish I could run a church like that. I'd make everybody give me the fucking Petty 12.5.
Yo, you would up it. In your face, Petty.
Finally, Petty. You get to understand.
Do you guys think it sounds like it? No. Oh, yeah, I don't either.
I think every fucking song sounds like it.
Sure.
Well, I won't back down. What's going on in the hall?
Oh,
shooter?
Party.
Fucking Columbine shooter?
I want to stick my head out.
Yeah, if I see you get your head blown off.
We're locking you out. Chris looks scared.
It was nothing. No shooter. As far as I know.
I thought maybe fucking Robert Earl Keane was going to be running down the hall. Shooting the shit out of everybody. You know where he's from too, Fez?
Party at the Moon Tower.
Down that way. Sherry was a waitress at the only joint in town.
Is it live?
She had a reputation as a girl who got around. What's that? Is what live?
The guy you're singing, is they're here now singing?
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Chris didn't even let me know he was coming. I'm a big fan.
Yeah.
Party at the Moon Tower. Party at the Moon Tower.
It's just like a, you know, like a movie song, like a whole little movie could be.
I want
like
a whole
that.
Movie. I want to know how much money, who did he kill? What happened?
You really can't follow that story? She killed. She killed the lawman.
Oh.
He went to jail.
That's what.
And he was
he
going
went
to
down
the chair.
For her.
Yeah.
I thought he just pulled it out. I didn't know she actually used it.
Yeah.
No. How else they gonna get away from the lawman?
Single shot, 410.
I just thought
the road goes on forever and the party never ends.
He loved her a lot.
Yeah. Fucking knew her for 5 minutes. Boned her 3 times, and she gets all the money. She's driving around in that fucking new car.
He's got a fucking Benz.
And where's he at? Old Sparky, getting his balls lit up.
And a six pack.
I'd be like, hey, let me help you out. I know where the bitch is.
Got an idea of where that money could be.
Did you like that, Fezzy?
That was nice.
Why weren't you singing along with everybody?
Oh, I don't. I would mess that up.
Did you hear how badly I did?
I would not send anything up. What could be messed up?
I was adding the Moon Tower part.
Seriously. Why didn't you jump in? I kept looking over at you. You had the lyrics up in front of you.
Yeah. I just have trouble jumping in with that.
I think you're a damn good singer.
I'd be a line or two behind.
Bullshit. You're a better singer than Tony Bennett. Tony Bennett isn't fucking good enough to lick your nuts. That's what I say to Tony Bennett.
He'd be honored to even get a whiff of him.
Him and Gaga.
Oh, yeah.
That's their real name.
They're always together now.
They're twins.
Sure they are. They're
like
fucking dating.
Twins.
Skeleton twins. That's a stretch. I don't know if that one of them is a skeleton. I'm doing a movie right now called The Red Skeleton Twins. I hope it fucking gets picked up. Clyde could... What was it? Clyde Cadiddlehopper?
Yeah.
Yes. God, my dad loved him.
Why wouldn't he? All right. You know, the Dan Aykroyd going, you know, very fast, but I'm going to leave it open until tomorrow. But he is the next guest on Unmasked. And I can't think. Seriously, I know 40 years of SNL. Tell me somebody you'd rather have from this whole thing other than Dan.
Bill.
Okay, you fucking went and beat us, all right? Feel good about yourself now?
But he's original cast.
Chris, you fucked up.
Yes, I did.
He fucked up by not getting him for this.
Yeah.
Or trying. You know what I mean? Put it that way. Cooley man didn't try. All right, that's it for us. Chris put a fucking knife in our backs. We might as well get going.